right, guys, I welcome you to today's class. We'll be handling how to write half equations. In the last class, we treated the redox reactions and how to know the species that are oxidized and the ones that are reduced. So we need to learn how to write the half equations, as it will help us to balance the redox reaction. Here we have an equation here, where copper and then the silver. So how do we write the half equation for reduction and oxidation? Okay, remember, we'll be considering the electron transfer. The half equation tells us the amount of electron that was transferred and the amount of electron that was gained and as well the one that was lost. Okay, so let's consider the half equation for oxidation. See, copper is what oxidized. Our copper was what? Oxidized. From 0 to plus 2, that's oxidation number, from 0 to plus 2. So there was oxidation. Why silver? From what? From 1 to 0. Now write the half equation for what? For copper now. So the oxidation half equation, we have our copper. So that means we have copper. How many electrons was lost? How many electrons was lost? It changed from 0 to what? To 2. To what? Copper. So now, the total charge on the left-hand side is not equal to the one at the right-hand side. So here we have two now, that's the charge here is plus two. Why the total charge on the left-hand side is zero? Now, we shall either add electrons or we remove electrons from either side. Remember, electron is what? Negatively charged. So when you are supplying electron, that means you are supplying a negative charge. So how do we balance this very what? Half equation. You have copper here, you have the total charge here is plus 2, why the charge here is 0. So that means I can either supply 2 electrons to the right hand side, or I can subtract 2 from the left hand side. Each one you want to do is correct. So let's add 2 electrons to the right hand side. So this is the half equation for what? For oxidation. Let's check. Copper here, charge here, total charge here is 0. Why the charge here is, this is plus 2. Remember, electron is negatively charged. So what we have here is minus 2. Total charge now here is equal to what? 0. So this is what the half equation for what? For oxidation. You can as well write it this way, by what? Subtracting 2 electrons from this side. If you have in mind that oxidation is the loss of electrons. So if you have that in mind, you can write this half equation like this. All right, the reason why I'm showing you this two ways of doing this is so that you will know that what we are doing is just to balance the charge. That is the half equation, showing the electron that was transferred. But you can also do that based on the definition of oxidation, which means the loss of electron. So look at this place. Copper lost what? 2 electrons. And then it changed to what? Copper ion. Meaning this guy lost 2. So let's consider this. This is 0. Here you have minus minus 2, which is equal to what? 2. And then you have what here? As well, 2. So the charge here is 2, 2. So in any way, you either supply 2 electrons to the right-hand side, or you subtract from the left-hand side, having oxidation what in mind. So this is the half reaction for what? Oxidation. Let's consider the half reaction for reduction. All right. Let's consider the half equation for what? For reduction. Remember, our silver was what? Reduced. So we have this. And then we have 2Fg. So in this case, we have total charge on the left hand side is plus 2. How? This is 2 here, this plus here. That means we have 2 ions of silver, or you can say 2 atoms of silver, but this time around, this is an ion and not an atom. So you have total charge here is plus 2. Why the one at the right hand side is just what? 2. So how do we balance this? We either supply 2 electrons to the left hand side so that the total charge we now have here will be what? 0 and then 0. That becomes the half equation for what? For this very reduction process. So cross from this side. So when I subtract 2 electrons, I'm going to have minus times minus is what? This is plus, and then we'll have 2, total charge of 2 here. what we have here is what? Is zero. So the entire chart on the right hand side is what? Is two. Why the chart here is what? Is as well what? Plus two. So that means this is the half equation for what? For reduction. And in this way, we have our balanced half equation for reduction. Remember, we as well consider that of what? Oxidation. You can either subtract electrons or add electrons, but have in mind that electrons are what? Negatively what? Charged. In summary, this is the half reactions, this is for oxidation, and this is for what? Reduction. Remember, the reason why copper, the charge of copper here is zero, is that copper here is an ion, is an atom, I mean to say. Copper here is an atom, but in this side, copper is an anion. And remember, anions are what substances that are what? That are charged, either positively or what? Or negatively. That is the reason why copper here is what? Is zero. And silver here as well is zero. The charge there because it's an atom. The easiest way to do this is to add electron to the side with the highest charge. So any place that is the highest charge, just add, supply electron to those other place. Look at copper having a total charge of plus two, here is zero. We supply two electrons what? To that very side. Look at this square, this side as well. You have total charge here is plus two, but here is zero. We supply two electrons to that very place. So the short route to do this is just to supply electrons to the side where there is what? More charge. So in the next class, we're balancing redox reactions. Thank you.